I think, you know, the next topic is, and I have been very intrigued with this, you know, because we had an office in Gurgaon, in up north, and a lot of glass in the residential apartment that we used to stay. And I just wouldn't figure out, you know, that why so much of glass we are using, and, you know, we are losing so much of energy, but it seems to be very rampantly used, you know, up north in Gurgaon and other areas. And then came along a project in Jaipur, you know, where the whole hospital actually from top to bottom is glass, you know, which was probably, in my opinion, maybe a criminal, you know, thing to do. But then that's the way things are at times, and, you know, we like glamour. But I think, you know, we're going to hear a little bit differently from someone who practices this and who, you know, sells, you know, these facade systems which are there. So the topic is called healing through glasses. We have healing through glass. We have heard a lot of, you know, architects and even CEOs speaking that you would like to bring in light deep inside, right? So we are going to hear from Mr. Sridhar, who's a marketing person from Structural Glass Solutions, St. Gobain. So can we have Mr. Sridhar here? Sridhar, I don't have your resume written down, so I will ask you only to explain, I mean, to talk about yourself, okay?
Hello, so good afternoon. I'm Sridhar, and I take care of marketing for Structural Glass Solutions, which is the division in St. Gobain for project sales. So basically, I take care of influencer engagement and brand presence in various industry summits for Saint-Gobain. So can glass as a material aid in the healing process? How do we build spaces that transform a hospital from a place of healing to a place of promise? So I hope to delve into these questions this afternoon. So for Saint-Gobain, healthcare is a very important segment. We see an enormous potential in this segment because the hospitals of the India of tomorrow is being built right now. Apart from satisfying the regulatory recommendations, it is also important that the new healing spaces we build are sustainable and take care of not just the patients, but also our Mother Earth. Let's look around us. What we see around us is just a tiny fraction of the buildings that will make up the India of 2030. Lots and lots of buildings are going to come up in the next 13 years. With so much of construction and built environment coming up, is that a good news or a bad one? I would say that today we are on the cusp of something momentous. We are in the right place and at the right time to set it better and to adopt sustainable building practices. For the healing spaces of tomorrow, sustainability isn't just the only criterion. We need to provide healing spaces that provide a holistic well-being to the patients, caregivers, and to every stakeholder. After all, a patient's surrounding has a major impact on the outcomes and on the staff's ability to do things effectively. It is in this context that the building materials have an important role to play in the healing spaces of tomorrow. What does a space that is ideal for healing look like? You would need a space that offers you comfort, hygiene, and provides you connect with the outside environment. A space that is in harmony with nature through the efficient utilization of materials and energy. We at Saint-Gobain did a 3-month study on how can one incorporate occupants' well-being into the design of a healing space. After interactions with stakeholders in the healthcare industry, we consolidated the findings in this healing space design guide, which we hope will be useful as a ready reckoner to help you to choose the right glass to inject well-being into your healing spaces. This compendium, it takes into consideration your varied requirements such as these when you're designing a healing space. You don't need to compromise or plan a trade-off to choose a glazing options that are appropriate for your needs and specifically chosen for your project through a shared consultative approach. We are happy to share with you some of the applications of glass in a green healing space. So what you see in the subsequent slides from now will be how these attributes of the products of Saint-Gobain will help you provide a comfortable and modern healing space. So the color scheme of the interiors influences the mood and the recovery of the occupants to a great extent. the recommendations from a study on the topic of healing, influence of colors, undertaken by Ron Reed, is presented in a Healing Spaces Design Guide. And researchers have found that patients recover faster when exposed to more daylight. In fact, recovery in well-lit hospital rooms sourced by natural light came down from anywhere from between 16% to 41%. And when we speak about daylighting and glare, so it can be a tricky combination to handle through conventional solutions, because usually we resort to a trade-off between daylighting and glare control. So typically, if you increase one, it also increases the other. So, but the question what we need to ask ourselves is there a solution where you don't have to resort to such a trade-off? Yes, so one such solution which I would like to speak to you today is called the Sage Glass. So this is our most innovative product that we are offering in the Indian market now. So in this peak, I'll just show it in action. So what we see now is a typical office space where the blinds are drawn to cut down the excess glare. So by doing this, we are losing out on the benefits of the natural daylighting and also the very purpose why we are having windows, which is to have a view of the outside. On the right side, what you see on the same office is a Sage Glass. So as you can notice, there are two tints on the single panel of glass. One light zone and another is a dark zone. This allows the light to come inside through the lighter zone, and as well as the darker zone allows you to control the optimum amount of light which can be set in. And not just that, in one single panel of glass, you can even have up to three light zones. So, and all these three light zones can be incorporated either at the same or the different level of transparency. So basically, you have four shades and four different tinting levels, which gives you a range of transparency from, say, 60% in the clearest state to the darkest stage, it would give you a 1% of transparency. And you can actually change the width of the lighting zones as well as the amount of light which you want to do it. So it is done custom on a customizable basis for each project-to-project basis. And so this is one of our project photographs of an eye clinic in Switzerland that is using Sage Glass. So amongst a global portfolio of Sage Glass projects, you can find a good number of applications in the healthcare segment. And when we speak about energy efficiency, we see that lighting and HVAC constitutes around 75% of the energy requirement in the hospitals. But it is possible to incorporate energy efficiency by the passive design in the planning of healthcare facilities. So by the proper selection of materials, the energy efficiency of the healthcare facility can be improved to a great extent. And we breathe around 12,000 liters of air per day, and it is imperative that the quality of air in healthcare facilities is of good quality and is devoid of hazardous indoor pollutants. So at Saint-Gobain's products, what we have is of low VOC, and it does not contain any of the harmful ingredients which is toxic to human health. A clean, well-maintained healthcare facility is necessary to prevent the buildup of material that can harbor potential pathogens. So it is imperative that the surface in a healthcare facility is easy to clean and do not allow the growth and the propagation of harmful microorganisms. Saint-Gobain's solar control glasses are manufactured through the process of magnetron sputtering, which deposits a thin layer of nano coating on the glass, because of which it confers it with special antimicrobial properties on the solar control glasses. So the materials that we use in the construction of a healing space should stand the test of time. This will help you to create long-lasting healing spaces that offer comfort to the occupants. So now I shall go through the different areas of application of glass in a healing space through the images in the next few slides. So here is an image of a high energy efficient facade. Here you have a reception area with glass in the wall paneling. A reception area with glass in the pillar and the wall cladding and partitions. A lobby with energy efficient glass in the windows. A lift lobby with glass in the wall cladding. A consultancy cabin with a writable wall partition and a countertop. An intensive care unit with windows that are energy efficient and provide acoustic comfort. And here is an operation theater that offers you fire safety and hygiene. A cafeteria with glass in the wall cladding. Fire safe areas with fire resistant facades offering up to 2 hours of fire protection. And as you can see, the only limit to the application of glass in a healing space is just our imagination. So in short, what I would say is a well-designed hospital can provide you with tangible benefits too. Lower hospital-acquired infection, reduced perception of pain, and shorter hospital stays. So I draw my talk to conclusion by saying that at Saint-Gobain, we see unique solutions that could make the healing spaces more functional and beneficial for all the stakeholders, the patients, caregivers, the facility managers, and healthcare workers. Thank you for your time.
Use glass for sort of psychiatric intensive care units, and what sort of glass would you use?
Do you have any products specific for any psychiatric units? What I would say is that these products which come into the portfolio of Saint-Gobain can be used even for a psychiatric ward. So a specific product for a psychiatric, no, we don't have a specific product per se, but these products which come under the portfolio could be used for that application as well. Any glass, if you do a process of toughening, what would happen is it would make it more strong and it would resist the chance of breakage. And even if it breaks, it would break into blunt granules which wouldn't hurt the patients. So it'll be you'd have seen the glass sharpeners, what you have on the cars after an accident, the blunt granules what you have. So those are the ones which happens as a result of the tempering process. After that, you won't have this impact injuries. So any glass which is toughened for that matter is risk-free in terms of breakage. Yes.
Thank you for this amazing presentation. And we as architects, we always have this brainstorming session regarding facade design. We come up with alternatives where some of the alternatives will have a lot of glass surface, and the other alternatives will have calculated fenestration sizes based on green building analysis, simulation, energy simulation and all. Now, when we are doing with lesser openings with smaller piece of glasses all over the facade against lot of glass, do you have any ballpark cost figures which will allow me to actually have more glass?
I'm sorry, I didn't get your question. You were talking about a lower window to wall ratio.
Yeah.
If you go for a lower window to wall ratio, I didn't get your question.
Area of opening.
Yes.
Against, for natural light and other things, and area of entire glass facade.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Because the cost, if I'm about to speak, it would vary upon the different products per se. So for a clear glass, the cost might be a different from what you use if you go for a performance glass, and that you have the different generations of product. So what we suggest is we have a design team who can actually help you with this calculation. So basically, they sit with you and they do the study for basically for the amount of opening what you want. So what would be the a costing for that thing, and if you want to increase it, how much it would be, and what would be the benefits what you'd be accruing because of that. So we have an in-house design team who will be sitting across the table with you and will be helping you out with such calculation, because it would depend upon the product per se and upon the generation of product which you use. So there's no ballpark figure per se.
Fine, thanks.
Hello?
Yes, so what I'm trying to say is, you want the minimum as well as what goes. Okay, so I would say if you go for the starting range of a performance glass in a double glazed space, it would cost you somewhere 2,500 rupees per square meters. Yes.
Regarding your...
So that is not the difference I'm speaking. I'm speaking of the absolute cost of a starting range of product.
You were talking about, you were talking about the sage glass.
Yes.
It is basically different type of tinting onto the glass. Now, how much of energy do you tend to reduce in terms of heat or whatever it is? You customize the whatever tinting to whatever extent?
Yes. Okay, so you want to know the amount of heat which would be reduced because of that.
Yes.
Okay.
Because so again, you have air conditioning in places where centrally air conditioned places, where if you have more glass, the more amount of light as well as more amount of heat.
Heat would enter.
So it is going to have an adverse effect. So what happens when you tend to have the sage glass and how much does it curtail the heat? By the virtue of which, what is the saving? You have done any sort of an analysis related to that?
Yeah, it has been done. So again, the amount of savings, it would depend upon the area of the zoning. So as you have noticed, like either you can have in the single panel, you can have it as one single zone, or you can have it as different zones.
Okay.
And each zone, like suppose if I were to talk in terms of solar factor, so which would mean the amount of, you know, percentage of heat which would be let inside the building.
Mm-hmm.
So in the clearest state, it would let in, say, like it would block around 48% of the heat.
Okay.
And in the darkest state, it would block close to 82% of the heat.
Okay.
So, I mean, like in specifics to that thing, it would depend upon the area of the glazing.
Okay.
I mean, area of the zones in each of the thing. And again, it's a dynamic facade because it would it would change throughout its scope of operation as well. So, I mean, I'm just giving the solar factor in the clearest state as well as in the darkest state. So based on that thing, it would vary in that.
What is the cost when compared to, as he was asking, the sage glass and the typical glass? What could be the cost ratio which comes into play?
Okay, so before I speak about the cost of this product, I'll give you a figure also. So I mean, what we need to also consider is that it would take into account the conventional shading solutions as well. Because I mean, if you were to compare the cost of this with the cost of glass, it wouldn't be, I mean, you shouldn't be taking the clear glass cost into account. You should be taking the cost of the whole system into place, wherein it will be the conventional shading solution, the glass cost as well as that. So for a figure, like it would depend again upon the size of the glass what you want and the amount of customization what you want in terms of the number of zones and also in the number of in terms of the automation, because this product it can be operated either through a switch on the wall, or it can, or you can have it as an app on your phone in which you can change the tinting levels.
So it automatically keeps changing with some sort of a
Like again, the third option is where you have sensors integrated, wherein it takes the information from the sensors and changes automatically based on the outside light level.
You have something like a lumen sensor which senses what lumens are coming in,
lungs,
and
yes.
Immediately it transforms, it changes.
Yes, it does that. Okay. So like again, it would depend upon the amount of automation what you want. But a figure per se, like it will be around 12,000 rupees per square feet.
Which is a phenomenal high cost.
No, like it's because you just wanted a figure, so I just killed it.
One question.
Yes.
So you mentioned about the glazed glass, I want to ask, like, if the position of the sun shifts, like, throughout the day.
Sorry, I'm not able to hear.
Like, during the day, the position of the sun changes.
Correct.
So, like, can we change the percentage of the glass, or like, is it fixed?
What percentage of the zoning you mean? You want to change the zones?
Yes.
I mean, what you could do is you could have, like in one panel, you can have the zones. Based on the position of the sun. So, like what I'm saying, suppose during the afternoon time, when the sun is at the apex, you could darken the top part and leave the bottom two in the transparent state. So that can be done. But in an operating building, you can't change the width of zones, because once you make a panel with a set width, it can't be changed in the course of its operation. So, the width is predetermined at the time of manufacture. So, and this width, it can be customizable for a project. For this project, if you want this much amount of width in the top zone, this much width in the second zone and third zone. That can be done before the manufacture, but like after it is installed and during its operation, that width cannot be changed, but that level of transparency, it can be changed in the various zones.
But the position of the sun changes, when the season changes,
yes,
then what you will do?
Okay, so you mean to say, how do we choose this zone? I mean, how
you have the concept for a particular season,
yes,
for summer. When the season comes, winter season comes, the position of sun will change.
Yes.
At that time, what we will do?
Yeah, for that, I mean, to determine the width of the zones, we do the sun path analysis of this particular project. So, it is done on a case-to-case project, wherein we do the sun path analysis for the different times of the day and different seasons, and based on that thing, I mean, we recommend the width of the zone which needs to be used. So, I guess it would be taken care of that thing in the sun path analysis, which is done to recommend the width of the zones which needs to be used.
Okay.
Thank you. No, be embarrassed. So, thank you so much, Mr. Sridhar, and I learned a lot. You know, these guys practice architecture, so they probably deal with you more. And I'm not really too much worried about that glass, which costs you that much. Maybe someday we will progress to that, level also. But the other part of it, I think, if you are saying 2,500 rupees a square meter, shouldn't scare quite a few of the clients with whom we work. I would now like to call upon architect Kashika to felicitate, and I'm pronouncing the word now correct, Sanguma. All right. To felicitate. So Architect Kashikar actually has come from all the way from UK. He works with the NHS, National Health Services, and don't miss him. He's going to speak tomorrow morning at, 10:15 and talk about how NHS runs its projects in a lean manner. Thank you so much, Sridhar. Thank you.